Hello music friends, welcome to Life Prog. It is Tuesday, time for a new video. And time for some coffee. It's always time for coffee. I'll put it away and let's talk about the music. A while back I did a review on Evergrey, Hymns for the Broken. And I mentioned there that that album was one of the most anticipated releases for the second half of 2014. Well, in this video I have another album that is one of my most anticipated releases of, well, of a long time. I mean, I heard about this album a couple of months, but basically I've been waiting for this album about 10 years because I reviewed the debut album of this band, but after that it kind of became quiet. So, and I really thought it was a shame that it, in my eyes, had ended, but that is until now. The band I am talking about is Cea Serin, and this band was formed in 1997 by Jay Lam and Keith Warman, and they created their own kind of music. They created a sound called Mercurial Metal. Oh, and just in case you hear some meowing, yes, my cat is in the house and she's making a lot of noise. Sorry about that. Just consider it background music. Alright, they created their own kind of sound, which they called Mercurial Metal. They're probably the only band in the world that makes this kind of music. Now, to understand what Mercurial Metal is, and I'm quoting here not just the first line of their biography on their own website, but also a line out of my review back in 2004, where they say that the sound of Cea Serin is basically an exercise in freedom of creative expression. Translated, you can basically do whatever you want. And that is the idea they had. They did not have any boundaries or limits when it comes to their music. And although they are definitely in the metal genre, it doesn't mean that their entire album is filled with just metal, or even an entire song is filled with just metal. It just shows that they can bring nuances in there and add elements in there that they think fit the song and the atmosphere they want to bring. Now, their debut album, and that is this one, I finally get a chance to show it, this one, Where Memories Combine. I'll bring it a little back, hope you can see it. It's a dark brown color with the stickers from the promotion company still on it. That's how I got them 10 years ago. And, alright, this album already showed that they created this really unique kind of sound. And even though back then, you know, 10 years ago, I had just started doing reviews, I was still a bit green, and even to a lot of music. I mean, over the past 10 years, I have listened and to a lot of music. I've learned a lot about music. But even then, I knew that this album was really special, that this album really stood out. And despite the fact that after this album, it kind of became quiet around the band, I kept on listening to this album, and still somewhere in the back of my mind I had that hope that maybe just one day they might be back. And that happened. They came back. It was a couple of months ago when I read a Facebook post from Generation Prog Records label owner Michael Schetter. He all of a sudden said, you know, Cea Serin is back, and I nearly fell off my chair. It's like, what? They're back? You're kidding me. So I went online, I looked the band up, they have a Facebook page, they have a website updated with information, but what most important, they had a YouTube clip with music of that upcoming new album, and I thought, wow, and I listened to it and it's like, wow, you know, it sounds just like I had hoped it would sound. It sounded really amazing. So I was really happy that this band got back. And then I was following them, of course. I mean, I really followed them very closely because, okay, there's a new album coming out. The band said, you know, we have the album, but we're looking for a label. And I had this feeling somewhere that it would work out, that label. And yes, it did, because they signed to Generation Prog Records. And I was not surprised about that. We have a brand new album with, again, a fantastic title. The Vibrant Sounds of Bliss and Decay. I really love these kind of titles because you can go so many directions with that, and that is something that really fits this band, because they can create this amazing music that is sometimes very mysterious, And sometimes you're wondering, what are they trying to do here? But you know, that is the nice thing about Cea Serin. They really bring fresh and entertaining music on their albums. Now, an interesting factoid about this album that I thought, okay, wow. Because they say in the liner notes on the album that basically this album was to gap the space between their first album and a new album that is still to come. And I thought, wow, okay, so this is an in-between album, huh? Really? An in-between album? This good? If this is the in-between album, I want to hear what they come up with next, because this album already is such an amazing album, such high quality album. The album has 5 songs, and with these 5 songs I can illustrate that gap idea, because they basically built this album up in such a way that you understand that this is indeed a bridge between the old work and something new. Because of these 5 songs, we look at the first 2 songs, Holy Mother and The Illumination Mask. These songs are older songs, even predating the debut album in 2004. They were songs that in another form appeared on that MP3 demo that the band released, somewhere in the late 90s. In those songs, you definitely hear the elements that you also find on the debut album Where Memory Combines, and the elements that I think makes them so good. It is driving metal with a lot of great guitar work in it, with a lot of great bass work in it, and with these haunting vocals by Jay Lamb, where one side you have these really grunts, these what I called back then Cookie Monster vocals, although he has his own kind of way of grunting, you know, that sometimes differs from other metal bands, but a very, very mean sound to it. But he also has a lot of clean vocals on it, and that is what you hear in these 2 songs, and they really breathe out the atmosphere that you also find on Where Memories Combine, yet maybe just a little bit more modern, because the songs have been reworked, of course, have been re-recorded brand new, and the band has an addition to the lineup, which I will talk about in a moment, that really also adds a lot of, well, a lot of beauty and a lot of depth to the music on this album. Then we have the 3rd track, which is nicely in the middle, which is a sort of a gate between the older and the newer work. And that middle song is very interesting, because that is a cover, and not particularly a cover of a song that I think, oh yeah, that one. I mean, sometimes you have these really obvious covers or think, okay, not a surprising cover, but in this case it is, because it's not only a cover of an surprising artist, but also a surprising choice of songs, because it's not the most known song of this artist. It's a song by Sarah McLachlan, and the song is called Ice. And they changed it a little bit, they changed the lyrics to work with a male persona, and they also changed some parts, the guitars moved into the piano, and so they did some changes to it. And that is a really beautiful song. I mean, you don't hear any traces of metal in there, you don't hear any traces of these grunts in there. It is a really beautiful piano ballad, a real singer-songwriter song. It is a surprising song, considering the fact that the first 2 songs definitely are metal songs with a lot of progressive and all kinds of other influences in it. And then you have this song. Then you come to the second half of the album, The Victim Cult and What Falls Away. What Falls Away is an epic track of 20 minutes on this album. So, wow, that is promising, very promising. Well, I can assure you, it is promising. These 2 tracks show the newer version of Cea Serin, the state of mind that they have been in these days, and the kind of music they now make. And I gotta say, I still hear a lot of elements from their previous album in there, because of course that is who they are, and I'm happy that they retained these elements in there. So we still have that driving metal, we still have the idea that they can do anything with the music, not just add metal, but add a lot of, as I mentioned, progressive elements in it, but sometimes also add some black metal elements in it, but also add some folk elements in it. So it's a really interesting mix of styles that they bring in here, and that makes this album stand out, and that is something that I love this band for very much, in the way that they create really fresh, really original sounding music. And I mean, if you, what can I say about it? I mean, the beginning of the Victim Cult, that shows how good these guys are. You hear this blend of guitars and bass at the beginning of that song, and that is so fantastic and works so well here. And that is just a hint of how good these guys are. And the track What Falls Away, I mean, wow, what can I say about that? I mean, it's a 20-minute song, and I was listening to it in preparation of the review, and I figured, what sensible thing can I say about that song? And only I can say is that it is 20 minutes of sheer musical bliss. That 20-minute song might be the best epic track that I heard this year. I mean, it is so fantastic when you listen to it. All the elements that Cea Serin is are all coming together in that track and expanded exponentially into something really epic and really grand when you listen to that track. And also the story of that formed the basis of that track. It's a really touching story when you listen to it. The liner notes, well, I can show them, of course. That is something I also found with the first album. You have the lyrics, and you have here the lyrics, and you have next to it, you have these liner notes where, well, you can get an explanation of what the song is about. Well, as you can see, there you have it. The interesting is there is not much other artwork in it, and there are no photos of the band. I mean, if you go to the website of the band, you can see some photos, but they are not the type that pose for promotional pictures. They more see it like a sort of an evil, a necessary evil, you know, that all right, yeah, people want to see the faces of the musicians, so yeah, we'll take some pictures. But for example, with the first album, they done something like this, you see? So they really don't want to have their faces on it. And in a way, it's a nice thing, because that shows that for them, it is not about them as persons, as artists, but it is absolutely all about the music. And the music speaks for itself when you listen to an album like this. It is, I say, it's an absolutely brilliant album. It is albums like this, same as with Evergrey, that really makes me enthusiastic, that I can really talk a lot about, and I'm really trying to hold in, because there's so much more I could say. I mean, we could go in depth in all these songs, but I don't want to do that. I just want to make you curious to the band Cea Serin. If you're not familiar with them, go check them out. There's a clip on YouTube. I'll put a link in the description to the Victim Cult. There you can listen to a track, and if that is something you like, I say you should simply buy the album, because the rest is sometimes even better than that song. I mean, especially I mentioned that track What Falls Away, that epic track. Okay, a little bit about the people behind Cea Serin, behind these two really amazing albums. I mentioned the names, of course. We have Jay Lamb, vocals, bass guitar and keyboards. Well, when it comes to the bass, to the keyboards, you know, musically this guy is really good. As I mentioned, one track, but also in the other tracks, you really hear some amazing bass work. There are nice keyboard parts in it. The keyboard parts don't really stand out that much, but they definitely add nice atmospheres to the songs. The bass stands out a little bit more, especially together with the drums. And then, of course, the vocals. And again, you know, I mentioned a few things already. There are a lot of grunts on this album. Not too much. A funny thing, when I read my review of Where Memories Combine, I read that those grunts were the only part of that album that back then, 10 years ago, I didn't like. That definitely has changed now, and I do like them definitely, but he also has a lot of clean vocals on it. And in the music, there are some harmonies in it, and sometimes really catchy choruses. When you listen, for example, to Holy Mother, but also other parts of the album, there you have these really catchy choruses that really will stick in your head and you really want to sing along when you listen to that album. Keith Warman, I have to be honest, I don't have much to say about him. He's the guitar player of the band. He brings out some really fantastic guitar work. When you listen to the album, there are really nice melodic parts in it, but there are definitely some heavier parts in it. There's definitely some shredding in it. Yeah, I know. My cat here is begging for attention again. But unfortunately, my attention is to you guys right now. At least that's what I'm trying. As I said, some shredding and some really fantastic guitar solos. And again, also with the bass parts in it, sometimes that really creates some nice effects in the music. So, you know, a great guy, absolutely. The third band member is new and was not present on the first album. I mean, on the first album, this one, there is a third person listed, but to be honest, I don't remember and can't find anymore what he exactly did. But on that first album, they had programmed drums. On this album, they have a drummer, Rory Fasciane, if that is the correct way to pronounce it. He is the drummer on this album, and he really adds a lot of depth and a lot of fantastic sound to this album and to this band, and that is really fantastic. And that is another thing that adds to all the elements that make this album so fantastic. I mean, I'm probably hugely biased because this is an album I really have been waiting for. You know, I've been waiting for this album to happen, and now it is here. I am holding it in my hands and I am so happy with it. I mean, I've been listening to this album a lot and I am truly happy that they really have a fantastic drummer. If you listen to the album, if you listen to the drum work on the album, it is spectacular. That's what I want to say about it. It's really spectacular, and altogether, that makes the music also spectacular. And that is definitely what I hear on this album. I think that Generation Prog Records did a very good thing by signing Cea Serin to the roster. I mean, they have a really interesting roster. It's not a lot of albums, but all of them are definitely quality albums, quality bands, quality music. So that's what I like, and Cea Serin really fits there. I mean, it's 10 years since their debut album, and I say that this band, Cea Serin, especially listening to these last two songs on this album, they have never sounded any better. I mean, you really hear that although they have retained the basic elements from their sound, you really hear that they have grown, they have improved, they have 10 years more experience, and that all shines through this album. So that is something I think is fantastic. I had high expectations, to be honest. Normally I try not to have any expectations, but in this case, yes. I had high expectations and the band surpassed all of them. I am really blown away by this one. So, you know it. I mean, I'm giving this album absolutely a 10, an A plus, just as I did with Hymns of the Broken by Evergrey, because this album for me, it is completely different, but I think it is just as good. So definitely a live prog must have. One of my, well, most loved bands, I think, in the collection that I have behind me. Definitely this is, and I'm really happy about it. So check it out, and you know, let me know what you think of it. If it's a deserved 10, or if you have a different opinion, let me know as a comment here on my YouTube channel. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, you can click on like or share. And if this is the first time you visit my channel, of course you can click on subscribe, so you will stay up to date whenever I upload a new video. Every Tuesday there will be a new video where I talk about music, an album, more albums. It all can happen here, so check it out. Of course you can follow me on Facebook and Twitter. I hope you guys will see me with the next video. My coffee is done. I'm gonna go get a new cup of coffee. Good night, everyone.